गुड मॉर्निंग बच्चों, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो आई होप यू ऑल हैव रिवाइज्ड द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लॉग व्हिच वी डिड यस्टरडे। आई होप एवरीवन हैज रिवाइज्ड द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लॉग व्हिच वी हैव डन यस्टरडे। यस, एंड यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड ऑल्सो ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद सम क्वेश्चंस। सो फर्स्ट आई विल सो फर्स्ट I will just we'll just write down the properties once again, and then we'll start with some questions. Okay, so the basic properties. Yeah, very good. So basic properties I will write once again. So first was I think log base b 1 was equals to 0, the first property. Second property was log base b is equals to 1. Third property was log base b a to the power m was equals to m into log a base b, third property. Fourth property was log a base b plus log c base b is equals to log of a into c base b. Remember, plus, from plus you will get multiplication of log, hai na? not vice versa. So you cannot, you will not get log a base b into log c base b is not equals to log a plus c by base b. This is not correct, hai na? This is correct, this is not correct. Okay, fifth one was log a base b minus log c base b is equals to log a by c base b, right? And remember, this is not correct. Log a base b divided by log c base b is not equals to log a minus b base c. Okay, these are correct, these ones are not correct, right? So I have mentioned this because I want you to remember that these, you should not make mistake in here in this kind of question. Okay, next, fourth, fifth, sixth, then we have log a base b can be written as log a base c divided by log b base c. Seventh property we can write as, so I'm just revising first so that we can easily solve question. The seventh property was log a base b can be written as 1 by log b base a, right? Eighth property was log a to the power log base a c will be equals to c. And ninth property, last property, was a log b c is equals to c log b a. Okay, so these were the all basic standard log properties. So just write them once and then we'll start moving to solving questions. First write them once, then we'll start solving questions. Okay. Which property I've missed? Can you mention? I think I've written whatever I could remember, I've written them. One property was this. Yes, I remember now. Tenth was log a base b to the power n is equals to 1 by n log a base b. Yes. Now it's good. Eighth property. Okay. A to the power, this will be termed as a to the power log c base a will be c. Simple. This is a to the power. Log c base b is c, hai na? You can write, you'll read it like this. Okay, so I hope these properties you have written. Please write it once, very fast. Please write it. Okay, write it. I'm waiting. Done, everyone? Copy them fast. Okay, now let's start solving some questions. So let's see. So the question is, okay, if you have not copied, you can copy it afterwards because you have already done yesterday. So let's see. So find the value of log 2 root 2 256. Find the value of log base 2 root 2 256. Tell me the value of log 256 base 2 root 2. Very simple question. Kaushik, you can copy afterwards. You now start solving the question. Hena? You copy it afterwards. Now just start solving the question. Anyways, we have already done. Hena? Start solving the question fast. 16 by 3. Very good, Bala. Very good. That is correct. Everyone else, solve it fast. Yes, Pradeep, very good. Very good, Jaipit. Very good. Okay. Yes, very good. Okay. So see, 256, by 256, we can write as 2 to the power 8. By 256, we can write as 2 to the power 8. So this I will write as 256 is nothing but 2 to the power 8. And 2 root 2 is nothing but 2 to the power 3 by 2. Right, so that means we can write this as log 2 to the power 3 by 2 into 2 to the log base 2 to the power 3 by 2 of 2 to the power 8. So this will be 8 will come outside here and 3 by 2 will come outside as denominator 3 by 2. So this is log 2 base 2. This will be 8 by 3 into 2. So this is 16 by 3. Right, very good. Okay, next question. Everybody understood? Write the next question. Find the value of find x if log base x 1 by 16 equals 2 minus 4. Find the value of x if 1 by 16 is equals to minus 4. But 2 root 2 is 2 into root 2. Root 2 is 2 to the power 1 by 2. So this is 2 into 1 plus 1 by 2. So this is 2 to the 2 into 3 by 2. Understood, Jay? Okay. Huh. 2 is, for this one, 2 is the answer. Yes, very good. So this we can write 1 by 16 is equals to x to the power minus 4. 16 is what? 16 is 2 to the power minus 4 is equals to x to the power minus 4. So from here we can compare. So x becomes equals to 2. Okay, very good. Next question. By very good, very good. Let's see. Find the value of log base 2 of log base 3 of 6561. Tell me what is the value. Maybe but chart test I will confirm and I will tell. Hai na? Krishna, test I will confirm and I will tell. Okay, I will tell you by tomorrow that we'll be having, are we gonna have a test or not? Okay. Okay, now concentrate on the question. Tell me what is the answer for this. Tell me what will be the answer for this. Okay. Okay. Should I solve? First you have, what you have to do, you have to factorize this. You have to see what can this be written. What is this? 6561 is what? What is 6561 in terms of power of 3? What is 6561 in terms of power of 3? Okay, yeah, answer is 1. Answer is 3. So 6561 we can write as 81 square. By 6561 we can write as 81 square, or this is 3 to the power 8. By this is 3 to the power 8, right? 6561 I can write as 3 to the power 81 to the power 81 square. Students are telling me, so I'm just writing as it is. Okay, I trust you guys. Okay, so this is log base 2. This we can write as log base 3 into 3 to the power 8, right? So this will become log base 2, 8 into log 3 base 3. So this will become 1. So this is log 8 base 2. This we can write as log 2 to the power 3 base 2. So this is 3 log 2 base 2. So this is 3. Very good, bachcho. Very good. Answer is 3. Very good. Understood? By everybody understood? Simple as that. Now see, you can see how simple log is. The solving like these, say log is very simple. Okay. Now let's solve some more questions. By this one, everybody is able to understand. Is there any doubt? If somebody is having doubt, then you tell me, sir, this is the doubt I'm having. Hai na? Okay, very good, very good. Excellent, bacho. So next question, let's see. So we have log 36 base 6 minus log 6 base 36. Tell me what is the answer. Kaushik, but were you able to get the answer? Kaushik, were you able to get the answer, bacha? Okay, two. I don't think Atish. I think no. These are not homework question. Three by two. Very good. 3/2 is correct answer. Very good. 1.5 or 3/2. Yes. Everyone else. See. Yes. 3/2. Very good. Sir, one second. In the previous question, how we can find root square for that much big? Arey. 6561. I do not know. So what I will do, I will divide. I will start dividing. So 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3, 3 8s are 24, 3 7s are 21. 3 7s are 21, 3 2s are 6, 3 9s are 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 3 243. Now 243 is 381 and 81. Now 3 to the power 9, 3 to the power 4. So 3 4, 5 6 7 8. But simple. Hai na? Okay, fine. So see, this is what 36 is, what log of 6 square base 6, right? So this will become 2 log 6 base 6. So this is simply 2 minus this is what log 6 base 6 square. So this can be 1/2 log 6 base 6. So this is minus 1/2. So 2 minus 1/2 is 4 minus 1/2. So this is 3/2. Simple. Understood? Yes. Very good. Kaushik, did you understood this one? Yes. Yes. Very good. Okay. Now see. Let's see. Okay. Log 6 plus 2 log 5 plus log 4 minus log 3 minus log 2 equals to what? Equals to what? Tell me the answer. Log 6 plus 2 log 5 plus log 4 minus log 3 and log 2 is equals to. Yes, bachche. Calculus is in maths. Right now you need calculus for some, but it will be in maths. Yes, Siddharth, that is correct. Okay, solve this one. Tell me what will be the answer. Base is E. So you can take base as 10. This is base 10. So this is base 10. All have base 10. Okay. Yes. Because generally we have natural log. So natural log is base 10. We will talk. We'll discuss why base 10 is important. We'll call this a standard log, I think. Hai na? We'll call it a standard log. Even I do not remember. Yeah, common log. We will call it as common log. Yes, log 100. Very good. See, so similarly, simple. What we can do? This is all base 10. This is plus 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 minus minus. So what we will do? Log base 10. 6 into 5 square. By this will become 5 square into 4 divided by 3 divided by 2. So this 3 and 2 gets cancelled. So this will become simply log 10 to the log 100 base 10. So this is 10 square. Log base 10, so this is 2. Simple answer is 2. Anna, understood? Fine. By till here, is there any doubt? Is everybody is able to understand the properties very clearly, right? The standard properties of log. Okay. Yes. Okay. Now see, if one more thing. Okay. So first thing. That now we will discuss about the graphs of logarithmic functions. Hai na? So first thing, let's see. We will talk about first with log base 10. Log base 10, x is equals to y. We will draw the graph of log x base 10 is equals to y. Hai na? Now again, if you remember what I said, that for to plot anything, if we do not know how to plot, so to plot any function, we will take different points and we will solve, we will just plot. Hai na? We will take different points on the curve and we will plot. Now, before that, first condition, there were some conditions on the base and on log values. First thing was that base, this was known as the base. So base should be greater than 0 and should not be equals to 1, right? Base should be greater than 0 and should not be equals to 1. Is it satisfying? Is 10 greater than 0? Is 10 not equal to 1? Yes. So that means this is base is okay. Okay. Fine. Next. Second was that this thing x should be greater than 0. X should be greater than 0. By these two were the conditions, if you remember. First thing, these two were the conditions, if you remember. Everybody is okay with these two conditions. By everybody is okay with these two conditions, if you remember. Yes, very good. Okay. Now see, what we can do is, now to plot this, first I know that first I will take different values. To plot this, I will take different values. So here I will take values for x. Here I will take x. So I will take x here and I will take y here. Okay. I will plot different values for x and y. I will find different values and then we will plot. And then we will plot. I will take some 6 or 7 values. Okay. So first thing is x should be greater than 0, right? So first I will take is x is equals to 1. First is, bachcha, I will tell, Vidushan, I will tell. First you copy, first you write this thing, I will tell that also. Hai na? Okay. First you take x is equals to 1. For x is equals to 1, what will be the value of y? For x is equals to 1, what will be the value of y? Tell me, for x is equals to 1, what will be the value of y? 0. Very good. Very good. Okay. For x is equals to 2, what will be the value of y? For x is equals to 2, what will be the value of y? For x is equals to 2, what will be the value of y? Okay. Just wait. Not 2. Take x is equals to 100. Yes. Sorry. 100. X is equals to 100. Or no. Not 100. X is equals to 10. For x is equals to 10, what will be the value of y? For x is equals to 10, what will the value of y? 1. Very good. For x is equals to 100, what will be the value of y? X is equals to 100, value of y will be 2. So we have seen some more, as we increase, if we'll take 1000, the value of y will be, if we'll take 1000, the value of y will be 3 and so on. As we keep on increasing s, the value of y will keep on increasing. This is okay? Fine. Okay. Now see, if we will take x as 0.1, what will be the value of y? If we will take x as 0.1, what will be the value of y? Minus 1. Very good. If we will take x is equal to 0.01, what will the value of y? Minus 2. If we will take x is equal to 0.001, right? Understood? Right? This is okay. So I will plot all these values first. I will plot all these values and I will see how approximately the graph looks like. So this is y-axis. This is y-axis and this is my x-axis, right? I do not require x-axis before 0. I do not require x-axis before 0. So I will rub this out. Hai na? I will now take different values of y. 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1 and 2. Hai na? I will take different values of y. So let's take this is 0. So this is y is equals to 0. This is, let's take y is equals to 1. Let's take this is y is equals to 2. And let's, I'll keep a little bit of distance. So this is 0. Let's take this is y is equals to 1. Okay. And this is 0, 1, 2. And let's take this as 3. Okay. So this will become minus 1. And this will become minus 2. Till here everything goes okay. Now let's take x as 1 here. Okay. Let's take x as 2 here. Let's take x as 3 here. X as 1. Let's take x as 10 here. X as 100 here. And like this. Hai na? So 1 for 1, it will be 0. So this will be the point. Hai na? So for 1, this will be the point. For 10, we were getting 1. For 100, we were getting 2. For 1000, we were getting 3. So let's take 1000 here, right? For 0.1, it will be here by x is equals to 0.1. X is equals to 0.1 will be here. X is equals to 0.01 will be here. So let's take. So now for 1, it was minus. For 0.1, it was. So the log function, when I will plot infinite points, so the log function will be something like this. When I will plot this curve, so the log function will be something like this. Okay, so if I'll draw this neatly, so the log function will become something like this. Okay, so first you copy this. Okay, the only point which you have to remember is this one. This point is 1, 0. Okay, fine. So just copy this one first. First you copy this one. For those also you will get random values. If you will not take 110, 110, 100, why am I taking? Because I will get very good values. 1, 2, 3. If I'll take some 2, then I will get in decimals. Hai na? So first you copy this, I will show this graph in decimals also. Don't worry, I will show this graph in decimals also. So we have this is x-axis. Fine. So just copy this one. First you copy this graph. So this graph is for log. This graph is for log x base 10 is equals to y. Okay. So one thing which we will see is few points which we came across. First is that this log graph is touching x-axis at x is equals to 1. First point to remember is that log x base 10 is cutting x axis at x is equals to 1. First thing, right? Second, the graph is here, it will move to plus infinity, and here it is moved to minus infinity. The second thing is log x base 10 range is minus infinity to plus infinity. So I can simply write it as r. By somewhere it is taking positive value, somewhere it is taking negative value. Third point is x is always greater than 0. Fine. These are the 3 points which we got. Okay. So first you copy this, then we will see the Desmos graph also. Okay, now see. Wait, bachcha, I will give answer. Don't worry. So for I'm drawing the graph for log. So I'm growing. So I'm drawing the graph for log base 10. Let me see log base 10. If I can find log base 10 of x. Okay, so see. How does this log looks like? This log looks like that it is just touching, right? So let's see. First is this point. Let's see. This point is which point? 1, 0. This point is 1, 0. We have seen that part. This point is 1, 0. Right? Next, as x increases, as x increases, log also increases. Right? As x increases, log function also increases. We can see this. As x moves in this direction, log increases. Right? As x moves in this direction, as x decreases from 1, right, the graph starts moving downwards. So that means here it is moving till which point? Here it is moving till minus infinity. If you can see, here it is moving till minus infinity, right? As I will move away, it will keep on going down. It will keep on going down, hai na? It will keep on. But see, the point is, it seems like that here it is touching. Right? It seems like that between minus 2 and minus 4, it starts touching, right? Let me just zoom in and let's see if it touches or not. See, between minus 2 and minus 4, between minus 2 and minus 4. Now see, as I keep on zooming it in, see. Is it touching? No. As I keep on zooming in, I can see that the graph keeps on. So suppose if here it seems like it touches, but if I keep on zooming, at certain point we can see there will be a separation in between two. See, the graph is never touching the y-axis. Okay, I will give you explanation why it is not happening. So first, it's a molecular gap, but there is a gap, there is a gap always. Now see, as I keep on moving right, the graph keeps on increasing, so it will keep on increasing, right? So see, so first is, just wait. So this is the actual graph of log 10. Okay. So, but how will we draw the graph? We will always draw the graph like this. So just to avoid any confusion, we will always draw the graph like this. So this is which point? This is point 1, 0. We will show a little gap in between like this. Like 10 graph we have drawn, we will show a graph like this and we will show it like this. So basically, from where to where it is moving? From plus infinity to minus infinity. So the range of the graph is minus infinity to plus infinity, right? And what is the domain of the graph? The domain of the graph is x belongs to 0 to infinity or real plus. Okay. Now, I hope this one is okay for everyone. We have seen the graph also. So this one is okay for everyone. Okay. Now see, I will explain why x is not less than one. Okay. So first, this one is okay. Okay. So let's see. So suppose if I'm taking log of base 10, log base 10, x is equals to y. First thing, so we know this can be written as x is equals to 10 to the power y. Yes or no? First thing, everyone is okay with this? Yes, very good. Now, if this is 10, x is equals to 10 to the power y, tell me for what value of y, x will be less than 0 or equal to 0. Tell me, what should be the value of y for which x will be less than 0 or equal to 0? Tell me. Does there exist any value of y such that x will become 0? Not possible. Understood? So that means this is the reason, because this is positive. this is positive. This is the reason why you have x as always greater than 0. Now, did you understood why x is the this is the reason? This is the reason why x is always greater than 0. Right? Even though y is a very small value, even suppose y is tending to minus infinity, even if y is tending to minus infinity, x will be equals to 10 is to power minus infinity. So this will be 1 by 10 is to power infinity. This will be a very, very, very small number. This will be a very, 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 very small number. Hai na? This will be a very, 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 very small number, but it will not be equals to 0. But it will not be equals to 0. This will be a very small number. Very small number. But not exactly equal to 0. But not exactly equal to 0. This is okay. Yes. So now see. So this is similarly saying that when y tends to infinity, x tends to 0. X tends to 0. Similar, same thing we saw in the graph also. So if I draw the graph here also. So same thing. Right? Okay. So as x increases, so this was 0.1, 0. As x increases, y also increases, but as y decreases, y tends to minus infinity, x tends to reach 0, but it will never be equal to 0. There will be a some gap. There will always be some gap. Always be some gap present. By everybody understood this concept? Yes or no? Everybody understood this concept? Yeah, but it is a real number, but very small value. Hai na? So just copy this one also. Bache, copy this one. Then we will. I will also tell you why base cannot be negative. I will also explain why base cannot be. Like 10 function. Yes. For like 10 function. 10 also does not touches pi by 2 line, but it is almost equal. Hai na? But does not touches, but almost equal. Hai na? First you copy this, then I will explain why base cannot be negative. Why base cannot be negative? Done? Everybody has done this one? Everybody is able to understand the concept? Okay. So let's move on to the next concept. Yes. Okay. Let's move on to the next concept. If you have not copied, you can copy afterwards. Hai na? So let's see. So next is log. Suppose we have log base B A is equals to, sorry. Suppose you have log X base B is equals to Y. Hai na? So now see. If I will take base as negative, so this will become x is equals to b to the power y, right? Now I'm taking base b as negative, less than 0. Base as negative, less than 0. Now see, what will happen? X will be equals to some negative value to the power y, right? By now see, y will be equals to 0.2 also. Y can be equals to 0.3 also. Y can be equals to 1 by 2 also. Y can be equals to 1 by 4 also. Y can be equals to 1 by 8 also. Right? Somewhere y will be even. Somewhere y will be odd. Right? So to plot this curve, it will be very much difficult for us. It will be too much difficult for us for to plot this. And also, for some places, you will also get undefined value. Suppose b I am taking as minus 2. Right? So this will lead us to x is equals to minus 2 to the power y. Now when y is equals to 1 by 2, it will be undefined. When y is equals to 1 by 4, it will be undefined. When y is equals to 1 by 8, it will be undefined. For all these value, it will be undefined. So for some value, it will be undefined. Also, when y is even, this will be positive. When y is odd, this will be odd. So this will be negative, right? Because, bachche, root of minus 2 is undefined, right? This is minus in under root. 1 by 2 is root, na? 1 by 2. So, this will be undefined. Understood? 1 by 4 is, hai na? Okay, fine. Very good. So, this is okay, I guess. That is why we will not take base B as negative. However, Let's check. So, base as minus 2. I think it will be showing not defined, hai na? yeah, base is not defined for this. If I will take, let's see something else. If I will take minus 2 to the power y is equals to x. Minus 2 to the power y is equals to x. See, it is not even showing, because even if I'll take minus 2 to the power x, if I can take, right, it is not even showing. Why? Because it is even the even it will be very much difficult for the for an application, for a computer based, for a AI to plot this curve, because for different points it will have different values. Understood? That is why the base. So this is the reason why base cannot be negative. Okay, this is the reason why base cannot be negative. Right, now you will say, sir, base is not negative, but you said base will also be not equals to 1. Bhai, are bachche, see, why, if suppose base is negative, for different values of y, you will get somewhere it is undefined, for somewhere it will be positive, for somewhere it will be negative. Desmos, it is not even showing the curve, because it is not inbuilt, because for Desmos, because, understood, fine. So that is what, so even Desmos is not able to plot, because it is also already fed that, okay, a base cannot be negative, you know? Because if for some places it will be negative, for some places it will be positive. So the graph will be very much sketchy. It will be broken many times at many places. So we won't have anything to plot this one. So that is why we will leave it all together. For some places it will be undefined. So that is why base cannot be negative, right? Now, I have also said that base cannot be equals to 1. See, the reason behind is log x base b is equals to, so suppose if I'll write log x base 1 is equals to y, right? Now, if you remember, we have written a property that log a base b can be written as log a base c by log b base c. Now, if I'll write this as, if I'll apply this property to this, so if I'll write log x base 10 divided by log 1 base 10. So this will be, by this is log x base 10, but what is this value equals to? This is equals to 0. So is this defined? By this 1 base 10 is equals to 0. So is this defined? No. So this will be log x base 10 divided by 0. This is undefined. Right, so that is why for this reason log base can also not be equals to 1. Understood? That means, hence, the reason that base cannot be equal to 1. Hena, understood? Yes. Fine. So this is one of the reasons why base cannot be equals to 1. Also for 1 to the power, or understood? Fine. So just copy this one. Then we will compare two different, now we will compare two different curves. In the same plot, we will compare two different curves. Okay. So just first you copy this one first. Fine. I hope everybody is able to understand. Okay. I will hide the chat screen. Just wait. I think you students are not. Yeah. Now you can type. Your chat won't be visible. Now you can write. Okay. Can base be 0? Nahi bacha. Base cannot be 0. By 0 to the power something. Log should be defined for that. 0 to the power something we do not know. 0 to the power something is always 0. So the value will be... value will always be undefined. You will never be able to tell what is the answer. Na? 0 to the power something is 0. So you will not have any particular answer. For that, you will have infinite answer. That is why base B cannot be 0 also. Understood? Vijay, did you understood? Na? So I hope this one everybody has copied. So now what we will do, because we have seen the log curve will be something like this. Now we will compare two different log curves. First is log 10. X is equals to y, and on the same curve we will draw log 2 x is equals to y, or we can draw 3 and 10. Let's see, 3 and 2, we will draw 3 and 2. We will draw these two. Fine. So first is, we know that x will be always greater than 0. Sorry. We know x is always greater than 0. So we will have something like this. Right. One thing is, by log, in both the cases, log of 1 will be 0 for both of them. So that means I will write log 1. So this is the point, suppose 1, 0. These both curves will pass through this. So first I will draw this. Suppose first I've drawn this. Okay, fine. So for different values of x, you will have different y's. So let's first write down y is equals to 1, y is equals to 2, y is equals to 3, minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. This will be sufficient for us to show. Okay. So now first thing is, for y is equals to 1, what will be this point? Tell me, what will be this point for y is equals to 1? What will be this point? For y is equals to 1, what will be this point? What will the value of x? This is log x base 3 is equals to y. This is 1 comma, sorry, 3 comma 1. This is 3 comma 1. 3 comma 1, right? What for y is equals to 2, what will be the value? Suppose this is y is equals to 2, what will be this point? What will be this point? 9, so this will be 2 comma 9. Yes, this will be, sorry. This will be 9 comma 2. Sorry, this will be 9 comma 2. So for y is equals to 3, tell me what will be this point? This will be 27 comma 3. By these three points are okay? Very good. For y is equals to minus 1, tell me what will be this point? One by 3 comma minus 1. For minus 2, this point will be 1 by 3 comma minus 2. And for this point will be 1 by 9, minus 2, 1 by 27, comma, minus 3. By these, all points are okay for everyone. Everyone able to understand all these points? How am I getting these points for everyone? Yes? Okay. Now, I will find the values for 1, 2, 3 for second one also. So, for y is equals to 1, for this one, y is equals to 1, what will the value of x? y is equals to 1, what will the value of x for this one? For y is equals to 1, what will the value of x? Yes. Fine. Okay. This one is okay. Yes. Just wait. So for 2, what will the value of x? For 2, what will the value of x? 4. For 3, what will the value of x? 8. Right? So let's draw these points. So for y is equals to 1, what will be the value of x? 2. So 1 comma 2 will be somewhere here. Yes. So for y is equals to 2, what will the value of x? 4. So 4 will be somewhere here. So y is equals to 3, what will the value of x? 3 will be somewhere here. 8 will be somewhere here. Right. So that means this curve will be something like this. Understood above. So let's see, for y is equals to minus 1, what will the value of x? Y is equals to minus 1, what will the value of x here? Y is equals to minus 1. What will the value of x here? 1 by 2. Right? Y is equals to minus 2. What will the value of x here? 1 by 4. For minus 3, it will be 1 by 8. So if we'll check them, this curve on the left side will become something like this. This curve on the left side will come something like this. Understood? Some of you are asking that how this will, so let's see. So log x base 3 is equals to minus 1. So x is equals to 3 to the power minus 1. So x is equals to 1 by 3, right? Log x base 3 is equals to minus 2. So x is equals to 3 to the power minus 3 is equals to 1 by 9. Now you understood, right? So basically this is log x base 2 is equals to y. Yes. So this is what I am. Samaj mein nahi. Dheer. Acha. Okay. So the base is 1. Log x base 2 1 is straight line. JP, don't think about base 1. I'm telling you log for base 1 is not defined. So don't even think about base 1. So what I'm doing is I'm just plotting the plotting different points, and I'm just plotting different point. So when I'm plotting different points, I came to know that log base 3 will be a yellow line, something like that, and log base 2 will be a green line like this. Both passing through same point, which is 1, 0. But this, now suppose, yes, intersect will be at 1, 0. They will always intersect. All log curves, no matter what basis, they will always intersect at 1, 0. Now in the same graph, now first you copy all of this. I will erase these part. First you copy this. This is always, this point of intersection will always be 1, 0. Okay. So I will rub these points because this was, I just wanted to show you, right? I will show in Desmos also. But first, I wanted to show you how Desmos will work. I will show in Desmos also, but I wanted to show you how Desmos will work. But before that, let's see if you can tell me if. Have you drawn the graph? Everybody has drawn the graph. Sir, the base is positive integer except one. Always the graph will pass through 0. Nani, for anyone, positive integer or negative, positive integer or positive real number, any real number. Everybody has drawn. Now, in the same graph, in here, same, you try to draw log x base 5 is equals to y. You try to draw log x base 5. Log x base 5. So where will log x base 5 will be? Here, first, here, second, or here, third. First, second, third. Which will be log x base 5? First, second, or third? After, yes. So by 2 was before 3. So 5 will be here. So right now, again, this left side. 5 will come here, 1, 5 will come here, 2, or 5 will come here, 3. 1, 2, 3. Where will 5 be? Third. Very good. Right? So that means the curve will be something like this. So this is log x base 5 equals to y. By everybody understood this part? So as base increases, this will be the condition. Now tell me what will be, where will log... So if I want to draw, suppose log x base 3.5, where will be log x base 3.5? Here or here or here? So I will mark 1, 2, 3, 4. Log x base 3.5, where will be log x base 3.5? 1, 2, 3 or 4? 3. Very good. So it will be 3. 1, 2, 3 or 4. On the left side, where will be log x base 3.5? 1, 2, 3 or 4? Understood? Everybody understood? Fine. Very good, bacho. Okay. So we'll check the same thing in Desmos now. We will plot the graphs in Desmos. So let's see. So here I will plot the graph in Desmos. Let's Desmos. So I will plot for different graphs. So this is log. This is also log. This is log a base function, right? So let's take this as 2 x, this as 3 x, this as 4, this as right. So if I'll zoom, see. Yes. So if I'll zoom, if I'm right. So see, basically. Yeah. So this is log x. This is log x base 2. Log x base 2. This one is log x base 3. And this one is log x base 4. right? So what is happening? As the base increases, the logs keep tend to shift downward on the right side of one and tend to shift this side on the left side of one, right? So suppose if I have log base 10, if I'll find the log of for base 10, so base 10, it will be like this. So base 10 will become here and on the left side, it will be here. So yeah, so base 10 will be something. Yeah, so base 10 also we can check. So base 10 also we can check. So this is function log base 10 of c. Understood? Everybody understood? Because why does it meet at this point? Because for all log base, any base, 1 will always be 0. For base 10 also it will be 0. Base 2 also it will be 0. Base 3 also it will be 0. So that means every log will meet at this point, 1, 0. That is why it is meeting always here. Understood? Fine? By this part is okay. Santosh, did you understood this? Why it is meeting at 1, 0 for all? Yes, very good, very good. So I hope now that log curve is some. Can you please log? So log sine x. Arey, bacha, that is different. So first you copy this one. First you copy this one. Okay, I hope this one is possible. Ashwin Murugan, what you are not able to understand? Log sine x, bachche, Surya, log sine x, you cannot form. Sir, it's not. Sir, why log is not for infinity? Infinity means, bachche, it's a very large number. So infinity, you can take any large number and you can define. You can find log base for any large number. Infinity means a very large number, right? So for a very large number, you can find. Suppose you are drawing log base b for suppose 10 to the power 1, this number, so you can form, you can find the base, you can sir, is it possible for a graph in log in straight line, means in straight line? I'm not able to understand, Ashwin sir. Then the log function will intercept only at, yes, it intercept only at this point. All log, any base will intercept only at this point. Is there a log for zero? No, log zero does not exist. Log base zero does not exist. Why they are not meeting at 1, sir? Why they are not meeting? Bachche, they are meeting at 1, 0. They are meeting only at one point, 1, 0. They are meeting only at one point. That point is 1, 0. Sir, it's enough to know this type of graph will be should we also learn the method, how it is done? Method is more important. Devdarshan, method is more important. Why? Because if you know the method, you can always derive any kind of graph. Hai na? Surya, what will it show if the base is 0.00? Now we will do for next kind. Yes. Will they intersect? Yes, they are intersecting at this. They graph, the log graph base B X will intersect at x is equals to 1. See, they are all intersecting, na? Bachche, why, sir, in exam, they ask graph for log. They can ask because log is normal function, so they might ask. Why they are meeting only at 1, 0? Because for no other value of x and y, you will have equal. For no other value of x and y, you will have equal term. So only at this point, they will intersect. Right. So for no other value of y, they will be same. For no other value of y, they will be same. And that is why they are mean. So the graph of natural log. And okay, this everybody understood. Now we will see the next concept of log. The next concept of log is weak base versus a strong base. The next concept of log is weak base versus a strong base. See, what does this mean? We have defined that base can be greater than zero. The base can be greater than zero or less than one, or the base can be, or the base can be greater than one. Okay. Base can be less than one, greater than zero, or base can be greater than 1. How am I writing this? By we already know that base should be greater than base should be greater than 0 and not equals to 1. So I can divide whole thing, whole base line into two parts. By this is 0, this is 1, and this is then more. So one base can be lie here. So base can be here, right? From this range, this domain to this domain, and then next one is base can be here. Base can be greater than 1, right? So previously, all these, if you look at them, base 3 greater than 1, base 2 greater than 1, base 5 greater than 1, base 4 greater than 1, all these I have taken for base greater than 1. These base, when the base is greater than 1, we will call them as a strong base. So in base, when lies in this range, that means from 1 to infinity, this will call as a, we will call it as a strong base. Strong base. That means strong base means just a base greater than 1. Hai na? When the base is lying between 0 to 1, we will call it as a weak base. We will call it as a weak base. I hope this one is okay. By simple definition, I'm saying is strong base and weak base. Strong base is when base is greater than 1, whose graph we have already seen. Right? And then we have weak base. Weak base will be when base is less than 1, whose graph we will see in the next class. Okay. So the homework for your next class, your theoretical homework for the next class is draw the graph. So homework is draw the graph for log base 1 by 2 x. Log base 1 by 2 x is equals to y. Draw the graph for log x base 1 by 2 x is equals to y. So what I'm doing is, because base, I know base can be greater than 0 and not equals to 1. Base can be greater than 0 and not equals to 1. So I will divide whole base into two parts. Whole base into two parts. That, okay, it is greater than 0 from here till here. This is from here till here. And base can be 1 to, base can be from 1 to infinity, right? So base can be from 1 to infinity. So this can be weak base, or I will write it once again. So my base can be 0 to 1 and from 1 to infinity, hai na? 1 to infinity. So this I will call it, this I will call as weak base, okay? Where base is from 1 to 0 to 1. And I will call it as a strong base. Strong base. Hai na? Where the base is greater than 1. Understood? Fine. Everybody understood? So now the homework is, I want you to draw the graph for log x base 1 by 2 is equals to y and log x base 1 by 3 is equals to y. On the same curve. First draw on different x and y, first drawn different x and y axis, then combine them, then drawn same x and y axis, and we will see the properties of these functions tomorrow in tomorrow's class. And I don't want to rush this weak base and strong base in one day, right? So fine. So I will just revise what we have done today. So what we have done some question based on the normal log properties. So this was your normal log properties, which we have done yesterday. Your 10 log properties. Okay. Right. Which we have revised. So these are your log properties. Right? Then what we did, some questions based on this, and then we started drawing the graph of log with a strong base. So graph of log function. So first what we did for log strong of log function with strong base, right? This I have not explained before, because first I just wanted to see if, we just wanted to draw the graph. Strong base means when base is greater than 1, right? This also base greater than 1, here also base greater than 1, here also base greater than 1. So all these graphs are for strong base, right? For greater than 1. Then after that, we saw the concept of with strong base versus weak base. Weak base means when the base is between 0 to 1, right? So now what is the homework is that I want you to draw the graph of log x base 1 by 2 and log x base 1 by 3. There are no other log properties other than these 10. Okay. So now I will just share the PDF with you. Just wait for some time. I hope today's class is clear for everyone. There is no doubt in today's class. Yes, very good. Okay. So we are going very slow. It's okay. Just wait. Do not write anything now. Just wait. I will share. Just wait. I'm sharing the PDF. Just wait. Let it get uploaded. Don't write anything right now. Just wait. Okay. Yeah, it has been uploaded. You can download it. Sir, is logarithm is related to quadratic? Yeah. It is a logarithm. Why am I teaching logarithm? First is that many students said that it is not taught in the class. Second is that log will be used in theory of equation in finding the solution. So that is why, Sir, we will learn calculus in maths. 12th bacha, calculus complete, integration, differentiation will be all in 12th. Okay. Fine. So you can just. Yes. So any other doubt you have? I think you are able to see the chat screen. Any other doubt you have, you can write. I will explain. I think any other doubt. Limits also in 12th bacha. PDF in private number, sir. Okay, fine. It's okay. No chat is not visible. Okay. Just wait. Okay. Chat. We will be doing revision for the term in the next week. From next week. This week, I just wanted to complete this thing. Your log, right? Bala, tell me what was the question. Can you write it once again? I can't get the PDF, sir. Okay, Samhita, you send me a message. I will send you. Sir, will they ask us to prove properties of logarithm in exam? Maybe in your board exam, they might ask. So it is important for you to remember the properties and how they are derived. If you remember the properties and how they are derived, you will. If you know the derivation, you will always remember the property. So please clarify if we have to do the first four question in quadratic equation homework. No, bacha, only the next four. So sir, for this week's test portion, our logarithm, right? Yes. If there is a test this week, we will have logarithm. Sir, I didn't receive the PDF. Okay, I will share the PDF once again. Yes, I've shared the PDF one again. Sir, will you give revision? Yes, bacha, revision will be from next week. I will 100% I will revise each and every topic which we did, but next week. But the pace of that revision will be a little bit fast. We will practice. Don't worry. Yeah, bacha. Okay, fine. I have doubt in 7th A and B, sir. Please help this. This is posted in Learnity. Okay, fine. Okay, I will check the. Fine. Chalo, take care. If you have not got the PDF, you can send me a message. Fine. Okay. I'll take your leave. Thank you very much.